why is abiding in the truth, in the self, for instance, like Ramana Maharshi did, why is that so rare? Because you can abide in the self for a little bit, but you will be aware that the entire world completely disagrees with what you're doing and thinks it's crazy. And this enormous pressure brings about a little bit of doubt, and you say, well, wait a minute, let me reevaluate this. Is this right to do? So even though you can reach the high points on the spiritual path, you can reach those, but can you stay there? Very few have stayed there, because the consensus in this world is so extremely aligned against it. Many of us have had glimpses, but we're amazed by those who remain constant, abiding in the self, abiding in truth, abiding as spirit, as being. It's amazing. How can they do that? I don't know. It's amazing to me too. Even though I have had the high experiences, the very, very top experiences, when I then focus on the world, it's like the world is just so intimidating as far as to say, telling me I must be wrong. For instance, I was in the presence of the Prime Creator on one instance, and even if you say, well, Prime Creator is not mad at all at us, is wonderful, just incredibly happy to see me, to see you, no problems whatsoever, just terrific, fabulous, wonderful. People will say, yeah, it was then, but you can't rely on it to remain that way. It's going to change on you somehow. And then you start thinking, oh, really? And you start doubting it, you know. So it's much more difficult than we imagine. And frustrating, because we can have those moments when we see perfect peace. We get a glimpse of it. But we don't trust it will continue that way, because people will say, we feel this attitude in the world that, you know, oh, you're really foolish to think it'll continue that way. You can't abide in it. If you abide in it, you're going to end up being betrayed at some point and have no fallback position. Okay, so there's all this type of pressure of distrust, mistrust from everyone. You can go out there and say, hey, everyone, I'm free, you know, I'm in perfect bliss and freedom, and I realize that reality is untouched by any dreams of its destruction. And people will say, oh, you're a fool, because you may be feeling that way now, but later on the destruction will come and then you have no fallback position. So they view you as very foolish. And of course, so nobody wants to be viewed as really foolish. It's very difficult to just ignore that. But that's what we all have to do. We have to get to a point where we know that it's not foolish, where we know that there is nothing that can change the intrinsic quality of reality. There's no betrayal there. There's no surprises there in that way. Never have been, never will be. You have to know that 100%. So these videos are designed to work on that, because only by working on this will you eventually get to the point where you can shrug off all the derision of people thinking that you're really foolish. You'll have to do that eventually. We all will have to be able to shrug that off and know that it's not true and not be bothered by it. So the most important key area of focus is to realize that nothing can change reality. Reality cannot be harmed or changed in any way. can't be harmed. Any harmful changes cannot suddenly become destructive. In other words, if you're in the presence of the Prime Creator, it will always be wonderful. It will never suddenly turn sour, or suddenly turn violent, or dangerous, or fragile, or vulnerable, or any of that. Never. Those who believe that it will are actually the ones who are continuing to work in this research laboratory we call existence, that we set up. They're continuing to work to try and find a way to harm God, the Prime Creator. So when they say you're foolish, they're simply reinforcing their own motivation to keep on working towards finding some way to harm God, the Prime Creator. That's what they're really stating. They're stating their own motives, which are actually, those are the ones that are foolish, because it's the attempt to accomplish the impossible is really foolish. And no, God, the Prime Creator, is not going to make them feel better by deciding to be affected by some negation and allow themselves to be harmed so that the researchers won't seem so foolish. No, it will never happen that way. God, the Prime Creator, cannot be harmed. Reality cannot be harmed in any way. Therefore, the way to go about it is to inform the researchers that they're engaged in an impossible, futile quest, and there's no need for that quest at all. They need to repent. They need to admit what they're doing and give it up. That's what has to happen. You know the story of the mad scientist who's so absorbed in research that they're not even aware of it. Their family, their wife, their family, their spouse, children, friends, nothing. Their home. They spend all their time in the research lab, frantically pursuing some sort of, you know, concoction, you know, some doing all these experiments to try and come up with something super miraculous. And they give every second of their lives, they sleep in the research facility, they eat there, they're madly pursuing some great discovery. Well, the fact is that we are all that mad scientist. That's what we're all doing. This existence is a research laboratory that we have set up to enable us to conduct experiments and try to come up with some way to negate reality. And all of us are madly engaged in this to such an extent that we have forgotten our true home, our true identity, our true inheritance, our true authority, our true capability, the way that we function, our true functionality, everything. We're absent-minded. Our mind is absent from the truth. We're so obsessed with this research that we're doing, these experiments. It's all existence is nothing but that. It's a research laboratory. And God didn't set it up. We set it up. Spirit set it up. God, the Prime Creator, is not looking to find some way to negate itself. Spirit is looking for some way because Spirit wants to be Prime Creator. Prime Creator is not mad about this because Spirit can't harm reality at all. No harm, no foul. Prime Creator doesn't want to retaliate against Spirit, saying, well, you're trying to destroy me, so I'm going to destroy you. No. It's absolutely foolish. Prime Creator knows that Spirit can never harm Prime Creator in any way at all. So there's never any basis for any retaliation or vengeance or anger. Zero. There's just a room for a good laugh because it's so funny. So silly. And if any of you can hear this and not flinch, listen to this in an unflinching manner, then for sure you're very close, very, very close. Because most will hear this and just jump back and really flinch away from it. It's shocking, scary. But how can it be scary to hear that you're not in any danger? How can that be scary? The only danger we're in is self-inflicted. It's the experiments we agree to take part in. We come here because we agree to take part in this experimentation. To be part of that. To express solidarity with this effort. To come up with some form of negation that works. So we test out, test out, test out. We've been testing out for so long in so many different ways. And we're continuing to do that with enormous cleverness and ingenuity. Now, if you're going to conduct these experiments, of course, you have to construct a research lab, right? So that's what we've done. And you also have to construct research subjects, which is what we've done. So the quest to find negation entails an enormous amount of constructivity to take place. Enormous. We have to set up things that look really nice, full of life, so that then we can negate them as part of the experimentation. So, what is it that's being very constructive? I call it the goddess of constructivity, because it attracts us in so many ways, appeals to us in so many clever, artful, beautiful ways, like seducing us to believe in constructivity. But the fact is, the goddess of constructivity is just a goddess of destructivity and drag. Okay, that's a true fact. This one dynamic of negation puts on the beautiful dress of constructivity in order to set up this research lab, in order to get all these subjects to experiment on, in order to get all of this continuing to participate in this experimentation. So there's always a goodness, a constructivity going on in order to keep all this research going. But it's really negation that's in charge of all this. The goddess of destructivity, negation, is the one, is the dynamic that is actually driving the whole thing. There aren't two goddesses, so to speak. Constructivity is just the goddess of destructivity in drag, dressed up to look attractive and appealing. So we keep believing, yeah, let's construct some more. Let's keep researching this. Let's build some more laboratories. Let's produce some more bodies to experiment on. Now, some people, a lot of us agree to come into the world and be the subjects of the experimentation. And then others come in to agree to be the more of the researchers doing the experimentation. So that's why you see those who in this world seem to have power over others, and others seem to suffer so much underneath them. But that's all basic. Those are all agreements that are made. If you're going to have experiment on rats, someone has to be the rats, and someone has to be this experimenter on the rats. But the goal is to find a form of negation that works to negate reality. So we're so willing to be experimented upon, so willing to be tortured and suffer and die, all in the belief that we're doing the sacrifice for the greater good of developing a form of negation that works. This is the truth. God knows, the Prime Creator knows this is true. You can check in on it. Just check in and say hello. How's everything? And God the Prime Creator will say, everything's great, everything's fabulous, wonderful. Welcome home. Great that you're communicating with me once again. And then you'll scratch your head and say, well, what about all this, these worlds and all this existence and everything? And then you'll remember, oh, I heard, oh yeah, it's just a research experiment. We're experimenting, we've just been experimenting all this time, trying to find some form of negation that would negate reality. And we haven't come up with anything, never will come up with anything. So why do you have to go back into the research lab? Why not just take a vacation from it? Decide, I'm going to close the door. I'm just going to put on, we'll be back some indefinite time, maybe. Close up the lab for a while. Maybe indefinitely. Don't go to work. call off the experimentation, call off the research. Give back your PhD. Your DD, Doctor of Death. Give that up too. Why spend all your time in research that will never come up with what you're seeking? So it's very simple, the situation. We're not in any real trouble at all, except self-inflicted. But that is a trouble. We are putting ourselves through the ringer. In every conceivable way, we keep coming up with new ways to pressurize ourselves, to disturb ourselves, to bring about deterioration, bring about stress and panic, fear, insecurity, fragility, frustration, agitation, despondency, despair, depression, dysfunction, death of all types, sickness of all types, intrusiveness, everything imaginable. We continue to put ourselves in this vast grinder of existence, this research laboratory, continually grinding us up. And then we re-enlist one more time just to show solidarity, you know, to be a good soldier. Don't have to be a good soldier anymore, because you realize the objective will never be reached. So how can you be really a good soldier if you're failing, completely failing? And you may say, well, I don't want to make other people look foolish. Well, you know, actually, when you see clearly, you help others see clearly, which is what they have to do. So they will continue to be foolish until they see it's truly safe not to be. And if you agree with their foolishness and go along with it, they will then have to infer that you're afraid of dropping it. You don't trust God, the Prime Creator, is untouched by negation. You must believe in the objective. So the only way to really help is to stop being a good soldier, drop the research effort, and let everyone else know that it is perfectly fine to do that. And then they will start to wonder, oh, okay, start to take a look and say, maybe all this effort is futile, in vain. Maybe it's time to drop those efforts. And they'll start seeing the foolishness of these efforts. It's the only way. Nothing wrong with realizing the foolishness of what we've been doing. It's actually a great feeling. You may think it's bad, but no, it's like, aha. Aha, I see, wow. I don't have to keep being foolish for millions more years. I don't have to keep sacrificing myself, suffering, going through all this torture in existence, misery. Even the good times get snatched away. Only it lasts a little while. Everything is bittersweet. Don't have to keep doing that. That's a great feeling. The more you realize, oh, what if that's just a mistake, a futile quest. Say, thank you, that's great to hear, wonderful. Means I don't have to keep doing it. Now, there are those who will continue their research, and they will look at you as you don't have the right stuff to come up with the answer. But the truth is, you've already come up with the answer, which means you do have the right stuff. You've come up with the answer that there is no answer. Okay? You've come up with the research conclusion that there will never be a form of negation that can negate reality. And that is the answer. So you do have the right stuff. It's those who are continuing to pursue the impossible who don't have the right stuff yet. Their minds are still very, very cloudy. But of course they'll put a silver lining on it and saying that they're the ones who are going to eventually succeed and be the heroes of the dream, so to speak, but are the heroes of this research effort. But there will be no heroes of the research effort. There are no heroes. There's no need for any heroes. Nobody needs to be a hero. What's a hero? There is no form of negation that works, so no one will ever find it. So there's no heroes there. Those who have thrown themselves away time and time again to try and reach this are not heroes, they're just fools. And then simply dropping the effort and repenting and going to God the Father and saying, Prime Creator, let me tell you what I did. I know what I did. I tried to find a form of negation that could negate you, but I realize now it's impossible. And I tried to deceive you by saying that I'm really trying to just protect you, trying to find these forms of negation that you're vulnerable to and then protect you from them. But I know that was just a cover story that I was using. I know that. So anyway, I realize it's impossible. And so I'm giving up the effort. And wonderful. That's it. Well, there's nothing heroic about that. Very matter of fact, very easy. It's all that's necessary. And then again, with the entire world insisting that you're a fool, it's not so easy. Easy in theory. But in practice, we've struggled with this. Because nobody wants to be an outcast, a social reject. But I have everyone saying, well, this person's mad, you know, crazy. So we have to take it from theory to practice. Continue to clarify just how clear and obvious it is, how simple it is, so that it won't get twisted around on you. So that when you have those glimpses, you can turn those glimpses into permanent experience. That's the goal. Permanent. Make it permanent. That's what collectively, that's what we're trying to do. Each one of us is aiming for that and praying for that, focusing on that, doing what they can to help others reach that, help themselves reach that. Very few have done it, but we have no choice but to do it. You have to do it. Right now is a very good time to do it because of the difficulties that lie ahead for this world. There's a lot of experimentation that's going to be taking place. A lot of intense research on negation is coming up now. The researchers are here in this world. They're raring to go. They have their research subjects all ready to go. So they're ready to start pushing those buttons and jumping headfirst into severe, intense research. And look, research into finding negation. They want to research all different types of negation right now, and they certainly will do that. So you have to just dismiss this as complete folly, and you just be very disinterested in it. Not even but worth following any of it. It's just a bunch of mad scientists, as so to speak, engaged in completely ludicrous endeavors. Silly. And yet they will continue that silliness. All sorts of suffering and misery and sacrifice. All of it believing, stoking the fires of their belief that they're getting closer to figuring it all out. Figuring it all out, how to negate God the Prime Creator. They believe they almost got it. They believe this time they're going to get it. They're going to find it. And I tell you for sure, they won't find it. They'll come up just as empty as they always have. That's the fate of existence, is to come up empty. Perpetually and forever comes up empty. So the idea of trying to replace the Prime Creator is an idea that always comes up empty. And therefore we don't want it. It's no value to us, no meaning to us. It's meaningless. It's a meaningless idea. We don't like that. So all we have to do is exchange ideas. Choose the idea of not trying to replace God, the Prime Creator. No need for experimentation. No need for research. No need for sacrifice, for victimization, for fragility. No more need for any of that. And practically, if you want to stay in this world, you'll have a feeling of absolute peace that no matter what events take place, no matter what research takes place, it doesn't affect that peace at all. And another option is to actually go to a place, the death-free realm, where there's no research taking place at all, where everything is immaculately, perfectly invulnerable. That's another option. That's a relocation option. Either way, you will feel complete safety and peace seamlessly. No matter what's going on, no matter whether research is taking place or not, it doesn't matter. Because you're no longer seeking negation. Therefore, you don't have to suffer any of the effects of negation. So, one can either relocate or stay here. Either way. All that one has to do is know the truth. Abide in the truth. Abide in the self. Repent and abide in the self. Give up the research effort. And you don't need the laboratory, do you? You can still stay in the lab if you want, but you won't pay it any attention. It won't bother you. Nothing will bother you. Or you can leave the laboratory. So I don't even need this laboratory anymore. Not necessary. Either way. Those are great options that we have now. All right. Very great. That's it.